Hello everyone, welcome to Krishna's online lectures. In this video, I am going to discuss one more concepts related to kinematics of motion. So today's topic is relation between circular motion and linear motion. So here I will discuss some equation which generally defining the relation between circular motion and linear motion. So here we will consider first motion of the object. And this motion we are defining as rotation. So here let us consider one circular path which is having radius r and it is also having one center O. So this O is representing the center of the circle or center of the circular path, and OA and OB are representing the radius of the circle. Now let us consider one particle is placed at position A. So A is the initial position of the particle or object. Now from this particular position, if this particle is going to start motion along this circular path in clockwise direction. So from initial position A, it will move and it will reach its final position B in a particular time period. Let us consider T is the time which is taken by the particle to cover this distance between A and B. A is the initial position and B is the final position. So here center is same and the distance between O and A and distance between O and B is same. So this motion will define the circular motion. So here this particular particle is covering a particular distance. Now let us consider this particle is traveling S distance along this curve. So here we are considering S distance traveled by the body or particle from point A to B on a curved path. And R is representing the distance of the body from the center of rotation. So this O is represented as the center of rotation and OA is represented as the radius of the circle, which is defining the distance of body from center of rotation. So here how we can define the relation between the circular motion and the linear motion, or how we can relate this motion and equation of these motions with linear motion. As you can see, this AB is a curve. Now, if we want to define the distance of this curve or total distance between A and B along the curve, so it is defined as per the mathematical condition, it will be equivalent to R into theta. Theta, we are considering the angle AOB. So first angle or the first term we are considering OA, and OA is representing the initial position of the particle from center of this curve or center of the circle, and B is the final position of the particle from the center of the circle. This OB is representing the distance of the particle from the center. So here this A and B is the curve or the part of the circular path. So this AB we can define on the basis of angle theta or angle AOB multiplied by the R. So basically we define the distance of the curve with r theta. So this S will be equivalent to r theta. Now if we differentiate this term with respect to time, so this will be ds by dt, that is equals to d by dt r theta. If we simplify this, so it will be r d theta by dt. So here this ds by dt in terms of linear motion we define as, this is defined as linear velocity in meter per second. Rate of change of displacement with respect to time is defined as linear velocity. Similarly, in terms of circular motion or curvilinear motion, d theta by dt is defined as the angular velocity. So this theta is the angular displacement, and if we are changing this angular displacement with respect to time, so it termed as angular velocity omega. So this equation will be v equals to omega r. So here we can say this linear velocity is r time of the angular velocity. Here this v will be equals to omega r. So linear velocity is r times of the angular velocity. So this is our first equation which is defining the relation between linear motion and angular motion. Now let's come to the next relation. So here we have this relation where linear velocity is r time of the angular velocity. So it is v equals to omega r. Now if we are again differentiating this term with respect to time, so it will be dv by dt, that is equals to d by dt omega r. Now if we further simplify this, so this equation will be r d omega by dt. Now as per the previous concept, we know this dv by dt is representing rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So it is defining linear acceleration and unit is meter per second square. And this d omega by dt is representing rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. So it termed as angular acceleration. And unit is radian per second square. So here in place of dv by dt we can put a, and in place of d omega by dt we can put r. So here we can define this relation as linear acceleration is r time of the angular acceleration. So this is our second relation, which is defining the relation between circular motion and linear motion. Now, as I have discussed in curvilinear motion about the linear velocity, so linear velocity we generally define in terms of tangential velocity, and for curvilinear motion, normal velocity we consider zero. So here only one component of velocity we will consider, that is tangential velocity in the terms of circular motion or for circular motion, but acceleration we will consider both tangential acceleration as well as normal acceleration, where tangential acceleration is defined as at and it is equals to alpha r, and normal acceleration is denoted as an, that is equals to v square by r, and it is equals to omega square r. So this relation is representing the relation between the terms like velocity, acceleration, radius, angle, which we are considering for a circular motion. And this is generally defining the relation between circular motion and linear motion. So here we have tangential acceleration and normal acceleration. So if we want to define the total acceleration, so total acceleration is generally defined by equation A, and that is equals to an square plus at square. So this is defining the acceleration or total acceleration. And in diagram, if we want to define the tangential acceleration component and normal acceleration component, so tangential we consider along the tangent. So tangential component of acceleration will be along the tangent, and normal component will be from this particular point toward the center of the rotation. So here this component we will consider as an, and tangent or the component along the tangent we will consider at. Now we want to define the resultant acceleration a. So this resultant acceleration we will consider at one angle phi, and this resultant acceleration will make angle phi with the radius of the circular path or with the radius of the circle. So if we want to define the angle of inclination for this particular resultant acceleration, so it will be phi, that is equals to 10 inverse at by an. So this is representing phi for the acceleration. And if we are defining in terms of angular acceleration, so this phi will be 10 inverse alpha t by alpha n. So this is the relation between circular motion and the linear motion, and equation which is defining the relation between circular motion and linear motion. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can rate, review and share this lesson with your friends and your known people. And if you want to watch more lessons related to mechanical engineering, please subscribe the channel.